My name's Sonu Lamba, and today we're making stuffed portobello caps. Mushrooms are my favorite. I love them. We are going to be using 2 portobello caps. We're going to be using a couple shiitake mushrooms, maybe 4 of them, 2 per mushroom. These are the shiitake mushrooms. I actually sourced these from Costco, the Redmond one, and these happen to be organic. So I was really happy I found these at the Costco over there. Shiitakes paired with portobellos add for a wonderful flavor. If you don't find shiitakes, you can use creminis, whatever mushrooms that you find. Just make sure they're not these, anything different. We're going to be using 1 leaf of Swiss chard. We are also going to use an herb. Mushrooms go really well with herbs. And I got some parsley here. This is curly parsley. If you can find Italian flat leaf parsley, that's the one to go with. I found this, so I'm just going to use it. We're also going to be using a tapenade. So this is a roasted red pepper and olive tapenade, just a couple of tablespoons. This will add some tart, salty, wonderful bites into our mixture. We are also going to use some extra virgin olive oil. Now, I am using one that's flavored with garlic. If you just have extra virgin olive oil and you have fresh garlic on the side, that's totally fine. Just make sure you crush it in a mortar and pestle, just so there isn't chunks of garlic coming into your mouth when you're eating your cap later on. Okay, next, we're gonna be also using a little bit of salt and pepper, and that's it. We're gonna bake these caps in the oven for about 30 minutes at 350. Okay, so the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna clean our mushrooms. So we never wanna wash our mushroom. When you wash it, it really doesn't cook properly after that point. It's too hydrated once you put water in here. So I'm gonna clean my mushroom with a paper towel. I'm just gonna wipe it and try to use these fresh. So when you buy these, use them within a few days. If these sit for several days or if it's in the fridge for a week, they're gonna start to wilt down and they won't be so fresh anymore. So I'm gonna go ahead, give this a wipe. Okay, so this is wonderful. These look great. Next, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and take the stem off. So you can give it a quarter turn or you can use a knife. I'm just gonna go ahead, give it a quarter turn. There's the stem. Came off really nice. Same thing here, quarter turn. Great. Okay, now I'm gonna go ahead inside here in the portobello mushroom. These are gills. they are edible. You can definitely add them to your mixture. Sometimes I do when I don't have guests coming. The only thing they'll do is they'll darken the final color of your stuffing. So it's gonna look, it doesn't look the most appetizing. So if I have guests coming, I usually remove the gills. If it's just for my family, they don't really mind. I add it in because it does have a really, really good flavor. But for this, I'm gonna go ahead and just clean them out. So I'm gonna put my bowl here. I'm gonna take a spoon and I'm just gonna go around and I'm cleaning these gills. So sometimes if you do add them into your recipe, they can give a really dark brown color to the caps. And I'm gonna go ahead, yep, take these out. They're coming out really nicely. Make sure you don't use too much force because we don't wanna puncture our cap. And you'll feel the resistance. Never ever go through the mushroom. And you're hollowing these guys out so you can stuff them later. Okay, that looks pretty good to me. Wonderful. Okay, so there's my cap right there. I'm gonna go ahead and do this for my second mushroom. And then when we return, we're gonna go ahead and chop our chard and get the rest of our toppings going. Thank you guys. So we have removed the gills of our 2 portobello caps. Here they are. As you can see, they look nice and hollow, very stuffable. So this looks great. So I'm gonna go ahead and next, I'm gonna take those 2 stems and I'm gonna chop them up as fine as I can. So the goal is to make sure these mushrooms still give a nice meaty texture in your stuffing, because this is a wonderful vegetarian entree. You can enjoy this with pasta. You can enjoy it with, you know, quinoa. You can have it with whatever side dish that you like, grilled potatoes. But this is definitely more of an entree than an appetizer. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and chop my stems here. Okay, so the stems of our portobello caps are in here. Next, I'm gonna chop up my shiitake mushrooms as fine as I can and add them in here too. So, and I have already wiped my shiitake mushrooms. Make sure you wipe yours, damp cloth or damp paper towel. Okay, so we're gonna take our leaf of Swiss chard. I may add another one later if I need it, but you wanna remove the central vein. So this red fibrous portion is the central vein. We don't wanna put it into the caps. It can be very fibrous and chewy, not very appetizing. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead, take my leaves off. Perfect, there's the fibrous vein. Okay, and I'm gonna chop this up. Chard is so good for you. Tastes really good too. If you don't have chard, you can add spinach, you could add kale, whatever you got at home. Okay, great. Next, I'm gonna go ahead and add my parsley. So just a little bit of parsley, maybe a quarter of a cup. And the parsley is gonna help perfume this mixture. We want these herbs to shine through because we want the mushrooms, the meaty mushrooms, to have an awesome flavor. So there's our parsley, in it goes. Looks great. Okay, next to this, I'm gonna go ahead and add a couple tablespoons of my tapenade. If you don't find tapenade in your grocery store, you can definitely use pesto, or you can use basil pesto or sun-dried tomato pesto. Both are readily available. This smells so wonderful. I love olives. So this is red peppers and olives in a wonderful marinade. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and add, let's see, about 2.5 tablespoons. In it goes. Great. And next, I'm gonna add my garlic-infused extra virgin olive oil. This stuff is fantastic. It smells so wonderful. I love this brand. So this brand is called Pones. It's very, very aromatic. It's definitely the real deal. When you are looking in your ingredients, make sure the number one ingredient is extra virgin olive oil. And, you know, the next ingredient should be garlic. There should be nothing else added to it. If there is, don't get it. Look for a better one. Okay, so I'm probably gonna do, let's see. I would say maybe 3 tablespoons of this garlic-infused extra virgin olive oil. Okay, next, I'm gonna add salt and pepper. You have to add a fair bit of salt when you're seasoning this. We're also gonna season our mushrooms. We wanna make sure this whole thing is salty enough too, not just our mixture. So, I would say at least 1/2 teaspoon of salt. There's my salt. In goes my pepper. Great. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and give this a toss now. And then after that, we are going to season our portobello caps. Okay. So I'm just trying to incorporate that awesome tapenade flavor into my mushrooms and my chard. And if you want to add more chard, go ahead. It's good for you. It'll give a wonderful texture. This already smells fantastic. I can smell the sun-dried tomatoes and the roasted red peppers and the olives. This smells excellent. Okay. Next, to this, I'm gonna add a little bit of feta cheese. I don't consume too much dairy, but I do love my feta cheese. And I think with the portobello caps, feta and goat cheese are remarkable in this dish. I don't recommend Parmesan, but feta and goat cheese, definitely. Okay, and I'm probably using about a third of a cup, a third to a half of a cup. So in it goes. Great. Time to season our portobello caps. So I'm gonna go ahead and take some of that garlic infused EVOO, and I'm just gonna add a little bit to my baking sheet here. Great. I'm gonna put my cap in. There it is. There's my other one. Okay, now I'm gonna go ahead and season my portobello cap. So I gotta add enough salt to this. I'm gonna turn it around, season the top. Great. Let's rub it in that garlic olive oil. Great. Okay, next to this, I'm gonna add my pepper. Okay, now I'm gonna go ahead and take my garlic olive oil and just put a little bit in here. Maybe a teaspoon. Great. That looks fantastic. Okay, so we are actually ready to stuff our caps. Okay. I'm gonna give this a mix with my feta cheese. If you guys learned anything so far, if you love mushrooms, definitely hit the subscribe button. That would be awesome. And leave me a comment. That would be great too. Let me know how your dish turned out. Okay. So I'm gonna go ahead and take this mixture and I'm gonna add it into my cap, just like that. In it goes. Switch over to a spoon, make it a little easier for myself. Okay. Some other dishes I like to pair with my caps are pesto linguine. You can do like an angel hair or a capellini in a white wine sauce with some herbs. You don't want to have any pasta that's very, nothing with tomato sauce. Keep it kind of like pesto would work, or something in like a light wine sauce, just so that this dish is the highlight. Other variations you can include, you could add nuts on the top. Marcona almonds chopped up would be great. You could do walnuts or pecans, also chopped up. Do not keep them whole. They will be too crunchy and crispy. You don't want anybody to ulcerate their palate. Okay, so there we go. So I've used up everything in my bowl here. All those veggies and herbs, they are in. Welcome back. So my portobello caps are ready to go in the oven. Do not cover them with foil. Let them be just as is. The mushrooms are going to release some moisture of their own. You want that to cook out. I don't want a watery mess when I'm done baking this. So in it goes in the oven. You can use anywhere between 350 and 375 Fahrenheit. I'm going to bake this for 30 minutes and then we will get to try it. Perfect timing yet again. Our portobello caps are done. So I'm going to take them out of my toaster oven and we're going to try them. Okay, so I'm gonna rest these down here. So I have let these cool for about 10 minutes. I'm going to go ahead and transfer one of them to a plate, and we will try them. Now you have the option of adding a glaze to your portobello caps. So I usually finish these with just a drizzle of a balsamic vinegar from Modena, so it should be sweeter. I don't recommend just a big bottle of balsamic vinegar. You have to use a sweeter one. So anything that you would, you know, dip your bread in, or if you would make a caprese salad, you know, with the mozzarella cheese and tomato, that would work well, a sweeter finish. So I am going to carefully transfer my portobello cap. Okay, so I'm gonna put just a few drops of a wonderfully sweetened balsamic, just like that, just a little bit. Okay, I'm gonna dig in. Bon appetit. This is so good. I love the combination of the portobello cap as a base combined with the shiitakes. The natural umami flavor that a mushroom conveys is very dominant in here. I love that flavor. I love mushrooms. Mushrooms are a wonderful substitute for vegetarians. If you're trying to find more vegetarian-friendly recipes, this is fabulous. I would eat this as an entree with, you know, maybe some grilled potatoes on the side, or maybe as a side salad. I love the sun-dried tomatoes from my tapenade. I love the olives, Kalamata olives. If you're gonna make your own tapenade, use the black olives, the Kalamata olives, not the green ones. They're a little too tart. I love the garlic. The garlic olive oil is totally perfuming this dish. It is fantastic. And, you know, to top it all off with that tart feta, it's amazing. You have to make this dish. Finally, the sweet balsamic really puts the whole dish together. So if you have this, great. If you don't, it's still excellent. So if you've enjoyed any aspect of my channel, please hit that subscribe button. Thank you guys so much. Happy cooking. Make this for Thanksgiving as a side. And keep watching my channel. Thank you guys.